So what is the difference between the readFile and the readFileSync methods in JavaScript? Let's find out in this video. So I have opened VS Code and I have made two folders, files and fs. In the files folder, I have two text files, Goku and Saitama. In the fs folder, I have two empty JS files, readFile and readFileSync. Now this readFile and readFileSync are functions in JS with which we can read the content from a file. To use that, first of all, we have to import the fs module. And to do that, we will write fs equals to require fs. Now, first of all, we are checking how to use the readFile function. And to do that, we will write fs.readFile. And here, the first name we have to give is the path of the file. Now, we are in the fs folder and we have to go to files. And to do that, we will write double dot files. And here, let's write goku.txt. Now, to tell you that if Goku was in the fs folder only, we would be giving only one dot here. Okay, let's keep it as it is. And now, the next thing we will do is how we want to read the file, and this will be UTF-8. And the third thing will be one callback function. And here, the first parameter is the error and the second parameter is the data. This error will come when we will not be able to read the file, and the data is the content of the file when we are able to read it. So we will use one arrow function, and here I will write console.log and data. So now if we run this file, let's write node readFile. We can see the content of the file is displayed over here, and that is Goku is the strongest. So now to make it look better, to make it better in the true sense, we will write if error, then we will log the error. Let's write error and then display the error, and else we will display the content of the file, and that is data. So now when we run, we will get the same results because this is not an error. So if I change the name of the file to something else, and now if I run, you can see that I am getting the error. Whatever the error is, we are getting. So let's change it back to the same again. Now we will try to understand the asynchronous nature of JavaScript. So and to do that, we will simply write log something else. Let's say Goku is the strongest, Vegeta disagrees. So now when I write, when I run this program, what do you think will run first? Ideally, if we run line by line, this text file should be coming first, right? So let's run and see. We can see that first is Vegeta disagrees, then we are getting Goku is the strongest. That means JavaScript is running line number 11 before it is running this function. And this is the async nature of JavaScript. Because this is an expensive operation, JavaScript is not blocking the code. It is first running this 11, which is a relatively less expensive operation. And then once the file reading is complete, it is coming back here and running this console log data, which is Goku is the strongest. And this is how one async code is being run. So now let's look at the file sync, readFileSync.js. So first of all, I'll just copy this code and paste it over here, and I'll change the readFile to readFileSync. And here instead of Goku, I will write Saitama. And here instead of Vegeta disagrees, let me write Genos agrees. You know Genos, right? The cyborg. So now if we run this program, what do you think will happen? Let's make it readFileSync.js. And we only see Genos agrees and we don't see anything over here. So why is that? And that is because the readFileSync is not being called like this. This is a synchronous operation. So this code will block and then this code will run. Now to call synchronous functions, we don't write it like this. There is a different way to write this. And for that we will write const, let's say data equals to readFileSync. And here we will first of all give the path, and or for reference you can also see here whatever it is asking for. The first argument is the path, and that is double dot slash we have saitama.txt, and then the next one is the encoding, and that will be UTF-8, and that's it. It doesn't call any callback or anything. So once it reads the file, the data will be stored over here and we can log the data. So now when we run this thing, First of all, the data will be executed and this thing will come late. So as you can see, we are getting some error. And why is there an error? And that is because we have not written files over here. Now when we execute, let's see. So as you can see, the content of the saitama.txt file is executed first. Now saitama is the strongest. Genos agrees. So this is how we are running the synchronous operation in JavaScript, because this line is blocking the code, and once only after this line is being executed, it is coming to line number 6 and executes this. So what if we have an error in this? And to do that, we have to write this function in a different way, and we can write the try catch block. So we will simply write try, and after this try is closed, and then we will write catch, and if the error is here, we will log the error. So now let's change the name to something else, and when we execute this, we can see that we are getting some error. So we are getting this error, and then we have the error, and lastly we have Genos agrees. So yeah, that's it for this video. Hope you found this video interesting. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any doubts regarding the asynchronous nature of JavaScript. I will also link the GitHub repo link of this code in the description below. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.